opprobrious or downright ignorant individuals. Society tells us that we cannot do anything detrimental to abolish their mere existence. Yet, some of us make it our duty to surpass guidelines narrated by insane judicial laws. Righteously, in our own hearts, we choose to massacre them. Whatever man needs to rectify our distortions, creating the result that all would commend if God was known for the action. Still, people walk today with knowledge of eventual devastation for themselves. They are aware, but when the dead encounter befall, all that needs to be said is, we are your jury. I am your judge.
What is it, sir? You are no longer a living your strength, and I am son. Your soul now boasts in a dying way. I would pay money just to see your face. Cry for help, and I be heard. Not a single fucking breath. Please, you feel the break me break down. As you ask me to, for
J. Friedman, guitarist, coffee drinker, philosopher extraordinaire. Mad Mike, bass player.
Patrick, drums. Rick DeRozier, all vocals. These guys all do backup vocals on the tape.
And we are
Retaliation!
Yeah! Alright, it's something a little different than what you would normally receive on with a demo tape. We figured since we can't speak with any of you in person, we might as well send a little
bit something extra here. Come at you all the way live! And God in the state prison. So, this is our demo, man. What do you guys think, man? It's been long in the making. It's a fucking ordeal for me, man. I'll tell you that. I had some highs and lows, man, through this shit, man. What you think, Josh, man? What do you like, man? The last one I played, that didn't really go that well.
Yeah.
I tell you, man, I wish we could have taken this bow, you know what I mean? But the way we all came together and got this shit going, it's like, you know, we kind of started out nowhere, you know what I mean? And as the tune started to progress, I mean, the band was progressing. The enemy, that last tune, I mean, you know, like you said, we just barely learned that and threw it down. Because, you know, I'm on my way out of here, we're getting short. But, you know, that tune there shows the direction that this band was going. It's, you know, it's a tune that I'm most proud of.
Absolutely.
I'll leave you.
That's what you want to
do. Well, from when we started, like you said, we started off not exactly knowing where it was developing into. You know, you can see that through the progression of the songwriting. You know, being, you know what I mean, the most recent tune, before that was the Mosher. And, honestly, I can't remember which one we wrote before that.
Who gives a fuck?
I know when we started with Possession, man. Hey, I thought, when I first heard that, when we first were doing it, I hated that fucking tune.
Hey, let me just put on one of our live tapes in the background here. Okay, here we go. This is a session we did, I'd say, sometime in July. You'll be able to hear it in the background. Well, let me see how it's picking up. Maybe I can bring the volume up a little bit.
So anyways, as you were saying about Possession?
I still cringe when I hear that tune, man. You know, I think, 19, I hope you're doing, you know?
That's my least favorite.
But I tell you, when I hear it now, though, after when we threw the harmony lines in and shit, I like it. You know what I mean? I like it better now. I ended up doing all right. But, I like Riot, man.
Fucking
like the groove and fucking Riot, man. Hey, that's a Mosh tune all the way, man. I thought the first day we listened to this tape back, man, I started hearing that shit, man, I just wanted to kill somebody. You know what I mean?
You know, in the concept of writing it all around prison, most of the tunes being related to prison, I think to people out that have this tape and are listening to this now, you know, you get more of an idea of really what it's like, you know, the emotion, all of our experiences we've put into this music, and I know I have into the lyrics. You know, we get really, I get, you know, I feel it inside when I start going, you know, up there singing.
First of all, I think everybody should understand about, you know, the only 4 hours a week of practice to be able to put into this year. We have more time, so yeah, you know, it's more valuable than you're going to be from the market. 100% better.
I know for me, man, this tape, you know, it's like, look, you know, we're like fucking dead, man, you know what I mean? This is like, to me, this tape, everything about this tape, it's like a lifeline, you know? And we're in here, we're doing our thing, and, you know, we're in here, you know, I'm 100% in my music. It's like, you know, just knowing people are going to hear this, you know, we don't have an audience, man, you know what I mean? We have a few guys coming out here, you know? I mean, really, you know, it's, you don't really know what an audience is going to think of it. Just knowing what's going on, it's
July 12th, 1995, when we did the outdoor concert up on the roof of this music bunker here, we did get quite an audience. You know, 250 people is not more convicts, and then you had all the staff that was there. They didn't know what the hell to think of this. I mean,
we did get some looks, man, you know?
know, afterwards we had many people we didn't even expect come up to us and say, hey, excellent, you know? You know, people out there 20 years old, 30 years old, 40 years old out there swinging their fucking heads to our music.
But get out of these guys and like me. You know what I mean? Fucking prison audience. They're the worst, man. They don't want something for nothing.
Yeah.
Even if you were good, man, they don't want to admit it to you. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. But people on the streets, you know, try, think about it. Imagine how hard it is for us to play in front of a bunch of comics who give a fuck less. They ain't paying for the show. You know, but we held that audience. If you can play in front of a prison audience, you can play in front of 10,000, 100,000 people.
In front of anybody.
You know?
Especially
when
we get back.
Oh, yeah.
But, you know, the thing that sucks about here, you know, like I said, the day you listen to that tape, man, it might fucking run too long. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. You know, it's like, I'm sitting there listening, it's like, nah. You know what I mean? It's like, you know, you can't get that feedback from people. Like, you know, I let you go up.
That would be me.
Yeah.
Larry.
Hey, that's our engineering. Hey, Larry, man.
Hello.
Hey, what do you get to say about this whole thing?
You got to introduce.
Me and Larry definitely had some moments with the fight to make it a mistake.
You got to introduce Larry to Charlie.
That's it. Larry, why don't you come out here for a minute so we can, pick you up a little better out here. Okay, Larry doesn't want to know.
He never wants. He don't want to be out here. He wants to stay as far away from me as he can.
We did have some moments in the parking studio. I thought it was going to
end that.
Hey, a couple of times there, I mean, I had this parking out of stress pits, man. I didn't realize what we made it. I mean, a couple of days there, I was fucking exploding inside. Like, you know, I was like, fuck this. You know what I mean? I hate this video shit. I like playing hard. You know what I mean? I like the energy of music. I had a hard time being in this fucking studio shit.
Well, it can get stressful being that, like we said, 4 hours a week to actually come down to the court. You know, it's taken us how long longer than we expected to ever finish this, you know?
I can't believe it.
Not only that, you're dealing with the stress of being waking up by bells, pounded by bells.
Playing child like shit,
wouldn't. Yeah, well, anybody tell me what a roof pay system sounds like?
Amplifiers.
Yeah.
I tell you, I had that 3 weeks then, bro. I don't know what happened. I couldn't even play.
Yeah. I had 3 weeks in a row, man. Not one fucking keep on my shoulder. I was
suicidal at that point.
I was ready to fail. Yeah,
hey, you didn't fight yourself, man. I'll be happy. So, I wish we had more time. I wish we could go another one.
I might just have to get busted so we can.
Well, you know, the guitarist, Paul Fredericks, he's hitting the streets soon. You know, anybody, you may even out there, maybe interested. You know, possibly checking out the situation. I don't know how Paul is about moving across the country or around the fucking world.
Hey, I'm going anywhere for the jam, man.
Contact, you know, me through the address inside the tape cover.
If
you don't have the address, then we have been featured in numerous zines, and we'll be featured in many more. As many as we can get into, as a matter of fact. Any zines you are interested in? Contact me at the address.
I'll be out soon. I'll be up in the chair.
Anybody who wants to donate equipment can do that too.
Yeah. Hey, by the way, as we sit here right now, it's fucking Halloween, man.
October 31st.
1995, dude. Yeah.
What a day to finish the demo.
Go figure. You tried Friday the 13th, but
didn't make it.
Hey,
yeah.
I wish this cup of tea was filled with some alcoholic beverages.
Any highlights about any songs while you
I tell you, about, you know, like I said, possession, That's the only one I really miss my friends. Oh, yeah, the rest of them I had. The first time, man, I'm happy with hearing shit that I did. A lot of times, anytime I really record anything, I hear myself in the back and I play it. It's like, what was I doing? You know? But on this one here, yeah, oh, man, you know, yeah. When I came out of my slump there, it was like, man, it just all came together. Actually, a couple of them were for the slump. There was a drunk dude, a riot to him. Now, my second coming close to him, and after that, I don't know what happened. We tapped up, we couldn't pull the shit. But when he came back, quietest and heavy, I'm proud of the record.
Well, if we're gonna meet our time schedule on this tape, we're gonna have to wrap up this little rap session here. And I'd like to thank everybody who bought the tape. Thank everybody who promoted us. I'd like to thank everybody in the band Retaliation. Mike,
DJ
Frederick, Jared, Jeff, Fitz, Ben, whatever you want to be called. Quite a few people have helped out and with us and given a little bit of their time so that we can get this done. So thanks to them. Thanks to my mom and dad, because without them, none of this would be possible, because dad handling all of the sales end of it.
Thanks, Mom, Dad.
Thanks, Mom.
Thanks, Mom. Yeah.
Okay.
Hey, if you like what you hear, man, drop
push us. Push us. Get us out there.
I want to say, I would give you some feedback.
Get us out.
Why is it okay? Tell us what you think of your band, music.
Tell your friends. Everybody's got to have this tape. We are the first prison death metal band.
That's it. You ain't going to hear it nowhere else, man.
Keep your eyes on us. Keep in touch with us.
Retaliation.
Retaliation. 1995.